Hello students, myself Ganavi, assistant professor, SDM College, Ujre. In last class we studied what are substituted acids, and example for that we studied halogen substituted acids as well as hydroxy group substituted acids. Example we studied, but in this video we'll study preparation of few hydroxy substituted acids. We saw already examples, so directly I am dealing with the preparation in this video. So first one is lactic acid. This is one of the example for hydroxy substituted acids. You can see there is a hydroxy group. Okay, so in one of the carbon, that is hydrogen, which is replaced by hydroxy group. So this is the example for hydroxy group substituted acids. So this lactic acid is used as a food preservative as well as curing agent and flavoring agent also. It is also used in the preparations of food. Next is lactic acid is produced commercially by the fermentation of carbohydrates such as glucose, sucrose or lactose, or by chemical synthesis. So you may heard this lactic acid, it is generally used by produced by the fermentation process. Okay, so we'll see the preparations. That is, there are many methods are given in the textbook. I am going to deal only one preparation here. So generally, which is used by the fermentation process, that process I am not going to explain. That is the chemical process I am telling here. That is from the hydrolysis of cyanohydrin. Okay, so this is the acetaldehyde. When treat acetaldehyde with hydrogen cyanide, where cyano group attack to the carbonyl carbon, as a result shifting of bond takes place. That hydrogen is attracted by this oxygen. As a result, we are going to get the cyanohydrin. When you hydrolyze the cyanohydrin, where the cyano group by the hydrolysis, the cyano group converted to carboxylic group. As a result, we are going to get the lactic acid. This is one of the simple method. Okay, that is about the preparation. Next, we'll see the chemical reactions of lactic acid. So, first one that is. Here also I am going to discuss only two important reactions. Okay, first one that is reduction. When you do the reduction of lactic acid, so in presence of hydrogen iodide at higher temperature, we can see there will be a removal of water molecule takes place, especially this hydroxy group removal takes place. As a result, we are going to get the propanoic acid. That is about the reduction reaction. So instead of this, we can use any other reagent also. Okay. Second one, that is action of heat. When you heat the lactic acid at higher temperature, so usually lactic acid, when you heat at higher temperature, two molecules of lactic acids simultaneously, which removal of water molecule takes place. As a result, cyclization takes place along with that. So thus one of the hydrogen from the one molecule, another is hydroxy group from another molecule. In this way, two molecules of water molecule is going to remove. As a result, we are going to get the cyclic product, that is called as lactide. Okay, so this is about the lactic acid's chemical reactions. Let us see one more example, that is tartaric acid. You may heard this. This is one very common acid. So it is occurs in potassium salts, in tamarind, as well as which is present in grapes, berries, etc. So this is the structure of tartaric acid, and it is also named as 2,3-2,3-dihydroxy, since 4 carbons, it is butane 1,4-dioic acids. That is the IUPAC name, and it is used to improve the taste of the oral medicines. It is used in medicines also. It is used in chelating metal ions such as magnesium and calcium. Even in medicines, if you want like magnesium or calcium to the body, in preparation of that medicines also the tartaric acid is used, and also which is used in recipes as a leavening agent along with the baking soda. So in the preparation of the baking soda also it is used, and it is used as an antioxidant, so to remove the toxic substances in body. It is also used as antioxidant. Okay, and it is one of the important acids in wine. It is also used in the preparation of wine. Okay, and it is used in foods to give the sour taste, and tartaric acids already which is having sour taste. You already know that usually all the acids which is having somewhat sour taste, even grape, even you have the, you know, the taste of berries, so they'll have some sour taste, right? So which is used in the foods which gives the sour taste, and as well as which is also used in the preparation of mirrors. Okay, so that is about the few application. There are many applications are there. I mentioned only few. Let us see the preparation of this tartaric acid. So I am going to explain one of the method called total synthesis. We'll see. So in total synthesis, that is organic carbon, when organic carbon is treated with hydrogen in electric arc, acetylene formation takes place, that is C triple bond C, that is CH triple bond CH, that is acetylene takes place. So when you treat that acetylene with the palladium in presence of barium sulfate, reduction takes place. As a result, we are going to get the ethylene. You can see the slide, ethylene. When you treat this ethylene with bromine molecule, substitution of this bromo group takes place. This double bond is going to break. It is like addition reaction. As a result, we are going to get the ethyl bromide. So in the next step, this bromo group, okay, so there, when you treat this with the potassium cyanide or maybe with sodium cyanide, etc., any cyano compounds where that bromine is replaced by cyano group, as a result we are going to get ethylene dicyanide. So that when you hydrolyze this cyano group, we are going to get the carboxylic acids. So in this way, when you hydrolyze, you are going to get the succinic acid. Once again, when you substitute this with the bromine, when you treat this with once again with the bromine molecule, substitution of bromo group takes place. As a result, we are going to get alpha-dibromosuccinic acid. So when you treat this with silver hydroxide, where bromo groups are replaced by hydroxy group, here you can see that as bromo groups are replaced by hydroxy group, as a result we are going to get the tartaric acid. This is about the preparation of the tartaric acid. There are many methods. I explained only one method here. We'll see the chemical reactions of this tartaric acid. First one, that is action of heat. When you treat this tartaric acid at higher temperature, when you heat this at higher temperature, we are going to get the pyruvic acid. That is one of the common name. Okay, so that is the first reaction. A reduction reaction, when you reduce this tartaric acid with the hydrogen iodide by the removal of water molecule, especially removal of one hydroxy group takes place. As a result, we are going to get the malic acid, and thus further undergo reduction, we are going to get the succinic acid. Totally, we can say removal of two hydroxy group takes place. It is shown in two steps. And we will see the third reaction, that is oxidation reaction, that is in presence of HNO3. We can use any oxidizing agent. Here I shown the example of HNO3. When you treat with HNO3, where in the first step, that is which forms the tartonic acid, further it undergo oxidation which gives the carboxylic acids. So byproduct I didn't mention here, so the byproduct will be there. So at the end, we are going to get the oxalic acid in the oxidation. And if you treat with milder oxidation, in oxidation HNO3 is a strong oxidizing agent. If you treat with milder oxidizing agent like Fenton's reagent, which oxidizes the tartaric acid into dihydroxymalic acid, you can see. So tartaric acid, if you treat with Fenton reagents in presence of hydrogen peroxide, which gives the dihydroxymalic acid. So in malic acid, which is having double bond, you can observe there. So which gives the dihydroxymalic acids. This is about the preparation of tartaric acid. Thank you.